Do what?
I hear something.
I don't hear anything.
I'm going crazy.
Aren't we all?
Yeah.
I love this color. Let's see what it looks like on. Hello? Okay, I know I'm not going crazy. This is ridiculous already. Really?
What do you mean, really?
What are you doing?
You know who's coming?
Who's coming?
Tony Sukar is coming. He's won Grammys. He's been all over the world. I have a chance to travel. Think about it. My perfect life.
One can only dream. But guess what? In 15 minutes, we have to be on set and you're not dressed. So hop to it. Let's go. Let's go. Come on, stop playing.
Today on BELatina,
we're toasting to the good life and breaking down wine pairing 101 with crafted wines from Rombauer Vineyards.
And then we're traveling to the belly of Peru with Latin Grammy winning superstar Tony Sukar.
And finally, prepare to be blown away by one of the most incredible performances of your life. Who knows? Maybe the king of pop himself will show up.
We are your hosts, Karent Sierra
and Chef James Tahhan. And you're tuned into BELatina.
I'm Chef James. Thank you for being with us. And today we're going to have an amazing and joyful time. We're going to talk about something that is a passion of mine and probably for you as well. Food and wine pairing. Wine and food is meant to be shared with those loved ones, family and friends. And talking about family, I want to talk to you about a family-owned business, Rombauer Vineyards, making great wines for over 40 years. And those are the great wines I'll be pairing today with the food. So if you're ready, let's go. So when it comes to Sauvignon Blanc, I think one of the words that best describes Sauvignon Blanc is freshness. It's very fresh, very crisp, light, and very easy to drink, especially on a hot day. When it comes to the actual aromas that we recognize when we pour, we're gonna find some tropicality in there, some passion fruit, some nectarines, peaches, very easy to drink. If you wanna entertain, you have people coming at home, everybody loves a great Sauvignon Blanc. So delicious, so fresh, very balanced acidity. How about we start with the pairing? Fortunately, many years ago, a beautiful book was written. It's called The Joy of Cooking by a member of the Rombauer family. And of course, I wanted to take some of those classic dishes, give them a little bit of a twist, and pair them with the Rombauer wines. So that's why I like to go with a beautiful ceviche. Ceviche is usually a plate that's typical from Peru and has, you know, a base of lemon and of course a lot of those cilantro notes, a tiny bit of spice most of the times that perfectly complements the wine because we continue the note of acidity, but obviously we bring it down a note when we put a spoon full of that ceviche in our mouth and then we sip the wine. Perfect. That's gonna take me to my next dish. And we're gonna go for this amazing halibut filet. I've cooked it, pan seared it heavily to get that beautiful caramelization on the top. I have some of that butter with garlic and herbs that I'm just gonna pour on top like that. Look how beautiful that looks. When it comes to a buttery sauce, I like to pair it with a Chardonnay because it's a wine that's also buttery, rich, and it gives you that oaky finish that's just fantastic and phenomenal. So I'm gonna pour that, give it a nice swirl. Just incredible. I love it. Simple, perfect pairing, And when it comes to pairing, I think that wine just elevates the whole experience of just a plate of food. You're complementing with something that will take your food to the next level. Talking about next level, you know that one of my biggest passions has to be grilling, barbecuing, and you see it all over my social media when it comes to the weekend. And I wanted to go with an interpretation of a country that I had the opportunity to visit for quite some time and work there, and that was Argentina. Argentina is known for their steaks and their barbecues and their sauces. That's why I've made a chimichurri. What's a chimichurri? Chimichurri is basically this sauce made out of a little bit of garlic and herbs, always fresh, olive oil, a tiny touch of vinegar to cut through the richness of the steak. Today, I've picked a New York strip that I think will go perfectly well with this Zinfandel. Zinfandel is gonna give me those notes of spice, dark cherry, red fruit. It's just perfect and phenomenal to pair with beef. One thing I love about these wines is how aromatic they are, and how, again, they complement and connect really well with the dish. I'm gonna give it a try. I think Zinfandel has to be the perfect pairing for a steak with chimichurri, simply grilled, and then finish it off with this delicious sauce that's, you know, going to complement in a way with all the herbs, the fattiness of the steak. Some of the acidity in there is gonna cut through that richness, and I like to just serve it like that. And honestly, food and wine are never enjoyed the same and are never as joyful as they are when you have people around, when you have friends and family. And that's why I've invited some people that I wanna share this with. You should follow me, and I'm gonna take my wine with me as well. Ladies.
Mira quien viene.
Of course, I wasn't just gonna cook for myself. I had to cook for you guys, so you guys could be a part of it.
And vino?
Of course.
Vino?
Of course, vino. I brought my vino. I served you vino.
Woo!
So yes. Please make sure you enjoy the pairing. Enjoy yourselves. Yeah. I'm gonna go back to the kitchen.
He never disappoints.
No, he doesn't.
Reagan, thank you so much for being here and for sharing your family's wine with us.
Thank you for having me.
I hope you don't mind, but I invite a couple of friends along because it's boring to drink alone. You can't drink alone.
And we're all about that. We love sharing food and wine with friends, and that's what it's all about. So I'm glad you guys joined us today.
So Reagan, tell us about Rombauer and how your family actually got into the wine business.
Thanks so much for asking about that. It's a pretty special story to us. After high school, my grandfather joined the military as a pilot, and then he flew for Braniff Airways as a commercial airline pilot. Okay. Actually, off a tip from one of his passengers, he moved his family to the Napa Valley for no other reason than a wonderful place to live.
Absolutely.
He started to learn about the wine business from local vintners, and my grandmother went to work to help them achieve their dream of having their own winery. In 1980, their American dream came true when they started Rombauer Vineyards. 40 years later, our tight-knit family and our wonderful team has brought us from our humble beginnings to one of the top recognized fine wine brands in America.
There's so many wines. If you walk into a liquor store or a wine store, you have thousands and thousands of selection everywhere.
Can you imagine? You get dizzy.
That's right. Yeah. So what sets Rombauer apart from all the
Great
other
question.
Vineyards?
Yeah.
It can definitely be intimidating walking in and you don't know where to start and you don't know what you should drink. And just like making wines, part of my family tradition, there's many families out there that sharing Rombauer wines is part of their family tradition. They've passed that on for generations, and we become a wine that's really special to them, and they share in their celebrations. I think really because they trust in our consistency and the value of our wines, and they really know that bringing a bottle of Rombauer wine is gonna create a joyful moment
it's
at
It's always
any.
A great time.
Yes, exactly.
And I don't know about you guys, but women, I mean, I think we are looking better than ever. And like
I
wine,
think so too.
We are aging fabulously with time. And that is
like
because
fine
of
wine.
Your wines.
That's right.
And much like we have some wonderful women here today, women in leadership's really important in our company.
I did read about that. And I am so proud.
That's
and
right.
That is what we at BELatina are all about. Empowering the Latina woman or empowering any woman from any society, from any walk of life. So cheers to Rombauer Wines.
Thank you.
Definitivamente.
Yes. Cheers. Well, I think what we should do is just like everybody is always invited to come out to the winery and have one of our wonderful tastings.
When are we going?
I'm there.
We need to get you guys.
Oh my gosh. I promise you, I'll be there soon.
I'm available tomorrow.
Yes, yes.
I can book the tickets. I'll meet you in wine country. We'll have a great time.
I look forward to it.
We
look forward to it. Absolutely. Cheers to all of you. To learn more about these beautiful wines from Rombauer Vineyards, visit rombauer.com, where you can sign up to receive updates from the winery, schedule a tasting for your next trip to California wine country, or find the wines near you.
You can also scan the QR code on your screen to get a full breakdown of this food and wine pairing at BELatina.com. And by the way, you need to stick around because coming after the break, we're gonna get back in the kitchen, make some Peruvian dishes, and guess what? I'm gonna have right here, right now, Latin superstar and percussionist Tony Zucca to make some noise, so you better stick around. We'll be right back. Welcome back to BELatina, folks, and I'm gonna take you on this incredible journey to a country that I truly love for its food and its culture, Peru. I'm gonna show you two mouth-watering dishes that are gonna change your life. Very simple to make, but very, very, very delicious. Of course, when there is food, there has to be music. I wanna introduce to you a guest that I truly admire. One of the most important percussionists in the Latin world. So let's give it up for Tony Zucca, señoras y señores. Yep. Yes. There you go. Tony, my man, what a pleasure.
Thank you. Well, we got some energy in the house.
Yeah, wow. Great. Thank you for being here. I'm so honored to have you here because you're one of the most talented guys I know.
Thank you. And I mean, you know, I try my best. Music is my life, you know, but trust me, I know about food, and I know about Peruvian food.
So welcome back to the kitchen. As I said, we're gonna make two amazing, delicious, mouth-watering dishes inspired by the cuisine you know well. So first and foremost, I wanted you to try something that I love, and it's called papas a la huancaína. So you get this very velvety, thick sauce that's just phenomenal. Very simple to make, as I said. We're gonna leave you the full recipe for the sauce on BELatina.com, but meanwhile, I'm gonna put it together. So ideally, you wanna boil some potatoes, and then we cut them in even pieces. Then we'll place the eggs like that. And then we take that sauce, and basically what you wanna do is start by covering the potatoes, the eggs like that, some black olives like that. Let me finish off with some cilantro.
Ah, yes. Phenomenal.
Thank you, man.
Man.
You like it?
The touch of spice is just perfect.
I want to make this dish that I'm very passionate about, and it's called tallarin saltado, but it's basically a pasta dish. So first of all, I'm going to start with a nonstick pan. By the way, my set of fry pans has a 50% off for BELatina viewers specifically, and all you have to do is scan the QR code that you have on your screen, and that'll take you to a special discount so you can get my fry pans and cook as delicious as we do here. So, first and foremost, I'm gonna take some oil, very hot pan, very hot. So, what I have here is a sofrito. We cook down, you know, some tomatoes, some onions, some garlic, some peppers, and we're gonna throw that in there, okay? I have some rocoto peppers.
Rocoto, of course.
Yes, we're gonna use a little bit of that to give it a little bit of character. Whoa! And that is
fire.
The key to a good saltado. Some shrimp, mussels, I have some scallops. Look how beautiful that looks already. And now we're gonna throw in a little bit of tomatoes that I chopped and cooked earlier, pasta, that I'm just gonna toss in there.
All right.
All right, tiny touch of olive oil at the end. So we're gonna take some of that.
Let me take it in.
Seafood pasta. I like those mussels as well because they almost make the plate look so pretty.
Claro.
So then we take some cilantro.
Uh-huh.
We chop, chop. Finish it off like that.
Ese es el toque, the touch.
How does that look?
fantastic.
Okay, so
fantastic.
I am gonna get in trouble if I don't invite Karen to come in.
Oh
and
yes.
Also try
oh
a little
gosh,
bit of this.
I thought
this.
You were never gonna ask.
I will
my
never.
My mouth is drooling. I'm just standing. I'm like, please, please.
I will never forget you, darling.
I hope not.
No, no, no. And of course,
because
I will serve
I can't
you some
cook,
as well.
But I can eat.
We're on the same page.
You see?
We're great friends.
Yeah.
It's a great
it's
combination.
I'm gonna give it a try myself. How about that?
Let's see. While he's trying, you guys make sure you stay tuned because coming up next after the break, Tony Sukar will grace the BELatina stage with an explosive performance that will have you dancing like never before.
Señoras y señores, that was absolutely amazing. Ladies and gentlemen, we've come to the end of this amazing show. Follow us on social media. We've left you everything down here so you can follow. Thank you to the dancers. Thank you, Tony Sukar.
Thank you so much. And thank you,
the
Chef
best.
James. And if you guys want to learn more about our show or want to be a part of BELatina, visit us at BELatina.com. Make sure to follow us. And now I just want a couple of
Ciao, ciao.
Yes.
Bye-bye. Let's go.